It's Professor Dave. Let's take the derivatives of trig functions.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We just learned how to take the derivative of a polynomial, but there are many other special functions out there, and we will have to know how to take the derivative of most of these as well. Let's start by looking at the trigonometric functions: sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, secant, and cotangent. We learned about these when we talked about trigonometry, so if they look unfamiliar to you and you'd like some clarity, go back and check out this part of the series now. Otherwise, let's move forward with the assumption that we understand what these functions mean and learn how to take their derivatives. Let's start by looking at the graph of sine x. Using the interpretation of the derivative as being the slope of the tangent line at any given point, let's try to envision what the graph of the derivative of sine x would look like. Well, at all the maxima and minima, the tangent line is horizontal, so the slope is zero. That means the derivative must equal zero at these points. Now, looking in between, we can see that from this local maximum, the slope of sine x will decrease until it hits negative 1, and then will increase until it hits 0 again at the next local minimum. So the derivative should look like this for that section. Then the slope of sine x will have to increase until it hits 1, but then decrease until it gets back to 0 at the next local maximum. So the derivative should look like this for that section. This pattern will repeat infinitely in either direction, so the derivative of sine x looks like this. But what is this? The function equals 1 when x is 0, and then goes to 0 at half pi, and continues on in this manner. Well, this is simply the graph for cosine x. So it is the case that the derivative of sine x is the function cosine x. What if we now try to take the derivative of cosine x? Well, let's apply the same logic that we just used, finding where the derivative must equal 0, and the places where it must equal positive 1 and negative 1. And we end up with this. This looks almost like sine x once again, as it is equal to 0 at the origin. It is just that it has been reflected across the x-axis, as instead of first climbing up to positive 1 at half pi, it actually goes down to negative 1. So the derivative of cosine x is negative sine x. From here, we can find all of the other trig function derivatives by using rules we already know. For example, we know that tangent x is equal to sine x over cosine x. So, if we want to find the derivative of tangent, we just need the quotient rule. That will give us cosine times the derivative of sine, minus sine times the derivative of cosine, over cosine squared. Evaluating these simple derivatives, sine becomes cosine, and cosine becomes negative sine. So this will simplify to become cosine squared plus sine squared over cosine squared. Let's quickly recall our Pythagorean identity, which tells us that sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1. So this becomes 1 over cosine squared. And using the definition of secant, we can express this as secant squared. So the derivative of tangent x is secant squared x. Using precisely the same approach, we can get the derivative of cotangent x as being negative cosecant squared x. Finally, we can also get the derivative of cosecant as being negative cosecant cotangent, and the derivative of secant as being secant tangent. So these are the derivatives of the 6 trigonometric functions, and it may be useful to memorize them. Now let's try some examples for practice. What about x squared times sine x? We know how to use the product rule, so this should be no problem. Let's set this up using the definition of the product rule, and then putting our two functions where they need to go. So for the first term, let's leave x squared as it is, but turn sine x into cosine x, since cosine is the derivative of sine. Then for the second term, let's turn x squared into 2x, and leave sine x as it is. That will give us x squared cosine x plus 2x sine x. And there isn't anything more that can be done, so this is all we need. Let's try one more. How about x over cosine x? Now we need to use the quotient rule. Cosine x times the derivative of x minus x times the derivative of cosine x over cosine x squared. Let's evaluate the derivatives, which for x will be 1, and for cosine x will be negative sine x. That gives us cosine x plus x sine x on the top, and that's all we can do. Before we move on, without necessarily having to derive them, let's at least familiarize ourselves with the derivatives of the 6 inverse trigonometric functions. They are all listed here, and they all are in the form of 1 over some expression involving x squared, often under a radical. These may come in handy depending on the types of problems you are expected to solve, and we will see these again when we discuss integrals. So as long as we memorize the derivatives for the 6 trigonometric functions, as well as how to use the product rule and quotient rule, we should have no trouble differentiating functions with trigonometric terms. Unfortunately, derivatives do get trickier than this, but before moving forward, let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.